praise God. Thank him for his presence in the room already. His goodness just overwhelms me. And I'm just grateful. I thank him for being so good and so kind. I admonish you just to think about not the things you don't have, not the things he hasn't given you. Think of all the things he has given you, the things that you do have, all the ways he's made for us. I'm just so grateful this morning. His love just overwhelms me that he thinks of us so highly. I'm like, you think, man, you are mindful of us in the littlest things? Things we think he don't care about, he knows. So I'm just grateful, and I thank him for being so good. He's a good God, and my praise this morning is to thank him for being so good. I give him my praise. I give him my worship. I don't take it lightly. He didn't have to afford us this opportunity. And because he did, I'm going to praise him. It's your choice to praise him this morning. And I thank him just for being good.
You are.
And you know what I was thinking? I said, I know why they say, bless the Lord, oh my soul. You know, it's like, it's different when people say, you just say it just because you know it. They say, oh, bless the Lord, saints. But no, bless the Lord, saints. Bless the Lord, saints. Oh, bless the Lord. We're going to be loud up in here. Our praise going to be loud today. If you don't want to be loud, I don't know what you're going to do. But we're going to be loud today. Our praise is loud. I'm so grateful for the word in this place. But I just know, when you know, you don't just say it. You mean it. You know what you're talking about. Then you don't have no problem when somebody say, you going to do praise and worship. Yes, I do. Because I always want to give him praise. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. So it don't matter what's going on, the good and the bad. If it's all in you, then that's what you bless him with all of it. So then, since I'm blessing the Lord with all that's within me, oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul. I'm so grateful to be here. You know what? I done come a long way. Since I done come a long way, my mind is made up to go with Jesus all the way. All the way.
How many got a made up mind tonight? Listen. The middle of my mind is made up to go with Jesus.
Burning, oh, everybody, 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 everybody
like you, my Lord. I'm so grateful. You know, it's just a blessing. My mind is made up. My heart is fixed. And it's because of the word that comes to work on you. You can't do it by yourself. You can't do it. You got to get that word inside of you. I'm going to read the scripture. Psalms 86:5. For you, Lord, are good and ready to forgive, and abundant in loving kindness to all who call upon you. All you got to do is call on them. Just Jesus. Sometimes you just say, Jesus, help me, because I don't know why I don't know. And he'll show you. He didn't ask you to know. He did not ask us to know. Call on him. Just call on Jesus. It don't matter. And give him your praise. When you're going through, when you coming through, when you get out, before you get in. So that's all the time. Then we don't have to worry about so much stuff. You know, I'm just so grateful. You know, I just tell you, being with him is just the best thing. And I'm so grateful. And he deserves all of my praise. He deserves all of our praise. I thank him for being in this place. I just want to worship and praise him. We're going to do this last song. And he just deserves all of our worship and all of our praise. I'm so grateful for the way he's taking us and how he's showing us himself.
Of the glory.
Just the way that he loves us.
Come on, everybody.
So all he requires is that we tell him thank you.
Lift your hands and bless
him. You know, give him praise. And I'm so grateful for that. That he loves us that much to correct us and to show us. He makes us a light in the world, you know? I am so grateful. Just think about where he's brought you from. Because I know we have some people that are guests or, you know, visiting today. Just thank him. Start to praise him, even if you're not sure why. Just praise him. And like, I call on his name and he'll show you. He's going to give you some stuff to thank him for. You're going to see his wonder outside, you know, the nature, the world. You know, you just look for him and you'll see him. Just look for him. You'll see him. And he will show you himself. Just ask, you know. I'm so grateful. You can play it, Chris. You can play it.
Come on, everybody. Open your mouth and worship the Lord. He's worthy of the glory. He deserves the praise today. Come on, everybody, all over the room, open your mouth and worship him. Lift your hands and bless him in this place. Your simple song.
Belongs to you, oh Lord. My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you, oh Lord. Yes. My hallelujah belongs to you.
Yes.
Y'all got to come on, say, my hallelujah. From the bottom of your heart, lift your voice. My hallelujah. My hallelujah. Then we simply say, you deserve it. Everybody, come on and come.
To thy house, O Lord, with rejoicing we come. And that's how we come, with rejoicing, because we know that we are thine. No doubt about it. We're certain. We're confident. We know that we are yours. And for that, we bless your holy name. That's what we come to do, is bless your holy name. For everything you've done, all that you're going to do, all that you have done, we bless your holy name. You're the God of glory, and we praise you this morning. We praise you with everything we have. Yeah, we're going to be loud this morning. We're going to shout about it this morning. We're going to tell it this morning. Our God is good. Our God is great. Our God is awesome. Hallelujah to your name. Oh, we bless you this morning for your goodness to your people. Oh, you've been good to us. Oh, my God, you've been good to us. Oh, we praise you. We praise you. We praise you. Hallelujah. Bless your holy name. God of glory, we bless your name. Oh, bless us this day. Everyone that's here, Lord, give them a blessing. Give them a real good blessing this morning. In the name of Jesus, pour your spirit out this morning. Pour your spirit out this morning. In the name of Jesus, bless your speaker this morning. We want to hear what you got to say this morning. That's why we come. We want to hear that word. That word. That awesome word. Bless your holy name. Oh, we bless you this morning. Thank you. Bless the offering. Bless everything that's done in your name. And that's how we come, in your name. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we come. Bless your holy name.
Bless his wonderful name. Bless his wonderful name. Give y'all a few more minutes to keep praising while I wipe down. And then you can find your seats if you can. Amen. Yeah, praise him in the hallway. Hey, I'm glad to be here too, Miss Evie. Good morning. Welcome. Well, I'm not doing the welcome. I am actually your program host, Mrs. Christopher Smith. Well, I'm Mrs. Orletha Smith. Christopher Smith's my husband. And I am glad to be here too. I am so glad that the Spirit met us here this morning. I am just overwhelmed. But the next thing we're going to have is our welcome from Mrs. Sally Craig, our First Wives president. If you didn't know, you're already here at Friendship Day, which is hosted by First Wives. Amen.
I want to say thank you for coming to Friendship. You're so welcome. I am so overjoyed because the Spirit met us here. That's no small thing. And so I say, be comfortable, do whatever. We're a church where you can really feel comfortable. If your heels is hurting, take your heels off. If you feel like running around, run around. If you feel like shouting, shout. Just have a good time, because the Spirit is already here. So just enjoy it, and welcome, and welcome, and welcome. And thank you again for coming.
Throw that out of the way. So that in the interest of time, I will continue by saying that the next voice you will hear is Miss Lila Walker with our mission statement, followed by our pastor, Wendy Howlett, with the First Wives History. Amen.
Good morning. Okay, sorry. I'm having a wardrobe malfunction. Oh, she scared me. I would like to thank the Lord and just bless his holy name. I am also happy to be here. He is a wonderful God. He is a gargantuous God. Oh my goodness, he's just wonderful, you know, and I just want to bless him. Before I get into the mission statement, I just want to say today is my 6-year anniversary. My husband brought me here on Friendship Day. And I ain't left. And Miss Joni told me, I'll never forget it. She said, I don't care what happened with you and him, you better keep on coming. And I've been coming ever since, so bless God. I wouldn't have it any other way. I love being here. So, yes, it's been a journey, but it's been a good one. So, being first and foremost, wives who fulfill our divine ministry as set forth by God in the Garden of Eden. The reference is Genesis chapter 1, verses 28, 29, and chapter 2, verses 18. And I would like to read that one. It said, Then the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him. We will be a helpmeet comparable for our husbands, promoting Christ in our everyday lives, being a ministry of outreach to other women, promoting healing for the spirit and the body, the soul and the body, offering help, ideas, and solutions for life and relationships for married, single, and young women, using the Word of God as our outline, allowing a forum for therapeutic discussion toward inward healing and rational reconciliation for married couples and especially married women, gleaning from our collective wisdom as wives to offer assistance to other women, establishing the design of a virtuous woman, Christian wife, according to the Word of God, using Proverbs 31:10-31 as our guide. And I also would, if you don't mind, like to read just a couple of scriptures from that Proverbs 31:10-31. A few scriptures stood out to me, and I said I would like to read a couple of those scriptures. I like reading scriptures. So it starts off in verse 10 as an excellent wife is an excellent wife who can find. She is far from precious than jewels. And then 17 says, she dresses herself with strength and makes her arms strong. 20 says, she opens her hands to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. 25 says, strength and dignity are her clothes, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and teaching of kindness is on her tongue. And the final one is, charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Praise God.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, beloved. It is just the goodness of God that even allows us to assemble. It is his goodness that affords us the opportunity to bless and to praise his mighty name. I am humbled still at being in the presence of the Lord. I bless him today. It is sort of fitting that I should do the First Wives' history, because the First Wives actually came out of my loins. It was birthed in me. And though we are named after the movie The First Wives Club, we actually should be the First Wives Ministry, because that's what we do. We got together, I want to say 1997, because I don't have my history print out in front of me, and at our home, about six of us wives. And I was like, we need a ministry where we can minister to each other with help and support. I knew we all were serious about our relationship to the Lord, and we were serious about being wives. And those two things can get heavy and weighty at times, trying to do both, at least for me. So we got together, we discussed things, and I have to say, First Wives Ministry is one of the oldest ministries in Blessed Family. Next to our Usher ministry, we are one of the oldest ministries. We grew from that point. It's like every time someone became a wife, we would take them out and celebrate them. We would invite them in. Most of them stayed when we invited them in. And we didn't want to just be a group of women gathering to complain or bash our husbands, so that husbands know we don't gather to bash our husbands. We actually gather to support each other. And out of that, we start having outings where we would take the children to the county fairs. We would have retreat, marriage retreats. We did other things in the body beside our collective thing of being and meeting. Sister Bridget Townsend, or Ellis at that time, she brought us the idea, we need to have a friendship day where we sponsor and allow others to come and invite people into God's house. We took that ideal and we have run with it ever since. So this is why First Wives Ministry hosts Friendship Day, because we have brought that ideal. We believe, as the mission statement says, of reaching out and being supportive, not just to other wives, but to the body of Christ at whole. There is so much hurting going on in the world today. People are confused and messed up in their mind, and the world is not making it any better. Oh, but the God that we serve, he is a comfort in the midnight hour. He's a help to the helpless. He's a holder. He's a keeper. And that's why we celebrate him. So if you are a wife, if you're not even in Blessed Family, but you want to be a part of a ministry that its mission is to help each other, to elevate the mission of our God and of Christ, you are welcome to join us. Amen.
Amen. I can say that First Wives has definitely been a blessing for me. I've gotten a lot out of it. I was just telling Miss Janet that I was grateful for something that she said in a meeting, because it helped me through this week. So it was a long time ago that she said it. So you never know when, you know, blessings will come back, especially when it's for you. When it's your time, it'll show right on up for you. You'll be like, oh, that's for me. Thank you. So moving along, next, we will have a musical selection from Reverend Marquis Clark, and following that, we will have announcements and offerings. Who's doing announcements? Somebody's doing announcements, and I don't know who. Oh, praise the Lord. It'll be Miss Jeanette.
Good morning, family. It's a good day to be alive. It's a great
day to be alive, especially when you're in the presence of the Lord. It's a great day to be alive, and I'm glad to be not just breathing and alive, but to be alive in Him. It's a great day to be alive. I love the Lord. He heard my cry. He pitied every groan. As long as I live in trouble rise, I'm going to hasten, hurry, hurry, hurry to His throne. As long as I live, Kristen, as long as I'm breathing. And trouble rise, trouble gonna rise. We're in the world not but trouble. Listen, I'm running. I'm running. Make your way to Him. He's the only help I know, Pastor. He's the only one that can mold me and make me. Oh, and fill me and free me, Jesus. Thank you. Oh, my God. I'm supposed to be preaching. Not preaching, praying. What am I doing this morning? Okay, singing. Thank you, ma'am. Okay. That's what this God will do to you. Man, you start talking about Him. Listen, He can have His way. Fill this temple, have your way. If I need to, woo-wee. I love him this morning. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. This song that I'm about to sing, it's simply, you know how you, if you're a believer, you've come to the Lord, and people you've left in the world, and you see them, and you hear about them, and you know they're miserable without God. And being a believer, you know how God feels about all of creation, and you don't want anybody left behind. So we just want to ask the Lord, listen, can you reach my friends? I didn't want to leave nobody behind. I know you love them more than I do, but can you just reach my friend? Will you just reach those unsaved loved ones, Lord? We don't want to leave anybody behind. Yes, you love them more than we could ever. We don't want to leave anybody behind. And we want to tell our story. We want to let them know your situation is not too hard for God. If He can handle me and you and you and you, honey, there is hope for you. Hope for you as well. Yes. I got a call from an old friend. We laughed about how things had changed. But I could tell things weren't going as well as he claimed. He tried to hide his feelings, but they only gave him away. The longer I listened, the more I kept wishing that I knew the right words to say. Lord, I know you love him.
This week's announcements are as follows. Midweek service will be Wednesday night at 7 p.m. Seniors Thursday this week at 11 a.m. while supplies last. Seniors 55 and older receive a free hot meal to go only. This month's menu is chicken and dressing, greens and yams. Youth Sunday school next Sunday, 8:30 a.m. Our upcoming November birthdays are Miss Kayla Clark, November 17th, Princess Cameron Smith, November 19th, Mrs. Arcelia Lopez, November 19th, Master Justin Patrick, November 22nd, Princess Arcelia Milton, November 23rd, Miss Margot Hollett, November 24th, Mr. Chris Smith, November 24th, Miss Kim Moore, November 24th. This week's Bible reading is starting on Monday, Luke 6, and we'll finish it on Friday, Luke 10. Today's floor schedule is Mr. Jimmy Craig. Next week will be Deacon Mo Galloway. Cleaning this week is Mrs. Virginia O'Neill. Next week will be Mrs. Portia Sparks. Our offering will follow this. Remember the prayer list? We've had so many in the past. Just remember some names and ask the Lord to help in the name of Jesus. Thank you.
Pastor Liz Gregory, her open heart surgery was a quadruple, was successful. So thank the Lord. They know we were praying, so I'm grateful. We are grateful for my sister. I told her, I didn't got mad. Now the devil didn't make me mad. He has to leave you alone. So amen. The surgery was a success. You have been welcomed, if Sister President doesn't mind. You have been welcomed this morning, but I see many of you have bought friends today. And if you came with a friend, you are our friend. So if you want to wave your hand or stand, we just want to acknowledge our friends today that are visiting with us. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
All right. That was the best part of the service, right? Giving. Almost the best part. The word is coming. So next we will have Friendship, A Perspective by Princess Aaliyah Gomez, followed by the introduction of the speaker by Mrs. Kristen Mayweather. Aaliyah is coming.
Thank you. Sorry, everyone. Okay, what friendship means to me. When I was asked to do what friendship means to me, I was scared in a way. I didn't know how to say it. When I prayed about it and asked God how I should do this, He gave me peace about it, and I felt confident. So the meaning of friendship is a state of mutual trust and support between one another. In other words, you need to have trust. Trust means to rely on someone or something. Trust needs to go both ways as well, meaning you need to trust your friend and they need to trust you. You also need support from each other. For an example, if you are hurt or need anything, your friend will be there for you. Friendship is not just something that happens in 2 seconds. It takes time to get to know that person. Take Miss Marquis and Miss Jamie, for example, or all the men. They all have been friends since, well, as long as I've been here. Friendship is when people get into fights and will always be friends after. They will always say sorry. Yes, it could take time to say sorry right after a fight, but it matters when you call or text them that you're sorry and you both won't let it come between your friendship. Proverbs 17:17 states, a friend loves at all times. Thank you.
Again, I get to introduce my friend. Pastor Michael J. Davis was born on May 11th in South Bend, Indiana. Being brought up in a God-centered home, it was evident that the hand of God was on his life. At an early age, God began to use Pastor Davis in ministry with prophetic dreams and visions, which confirmed to his parents that he had been called to ministry. Being sensitive to the call on Pastor Davis's life, his mother took him to a live TBN taping where Dr. Oral Roberts was ministering. It was at this service that a prayer of miracles and deliverance was prayed over Pastor Davis. Many years later, he would attend and graduate from Oral Roberts University. This experience would afford Evangelist Davis to receive prayer and ministry guidance from several world-renowned men and women of God. Graduating from Oral Roberts University, led Elder Davis to return home to Indiana to co-found the Praise Fellowship Church with his family. He served as pastor of Evangelistic Ministries and youth pastor for 6 years. Pastor Davis then became the senior pastor of Praise Fellowship Church for 3 years before relocating to Los Angeles, California. In Los Angeles, Pastor Davis served as youth pastor at the West Angeles Church of God in Christ. This experience not only created a new ministry platform, but it gave Pastor Davis the administrative tools to do ministry in excellence. After several years of serving as youth pastor at West Angeles, God led Elder Davis to go back on the field of evangelism and carry the fire of revival around the world. Pastor Davis is blessed to be a husband and father of two. His goal in ministry is to go into a dying world and speak life. Amen. So we're going to have a good word today. Can we stand?
Yes.
Come on, let's clap our hands for Jesus. Come on, if you're glad that you made it through 18 months of being at home, isolated from people, but now you're able to come out and celebrate God, come on, you ought to celebrate that and thank God. Father, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for allowing us to be in your house. We pray that as we minister your word, that you will touch hearts, that you will touch minds. Bless the pastor of this church. Bless the First Wives Club. God, we thank you for what you're doing in their lives, and we thank you for the transformation that will happen in this community as a result of the work that is being done here in this church. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Come on now, if you're glad that you're happy, if you're happy that you're glad, come on, clap your hands and give God praise as you take your seats. Amen. What an honor it is to be in the house of the Lord one more time. I really say that, and I may be a little extra excited because I have not been in a setting where we're actually preaching in a church in quite a long time. I've mastered the art of preaching in an empty room with somebody on the organ, and we have church in there by ourselves. But it's good to be in the house of the Lord and to be with you all, my brothers and sisters. Will you help me to celebrate this dynamic, awesome pastor? Come on, let's celebrate Pastor Howlett. Amen. This power couple that's doing some amazing things in the community. Thank God for you. Amen. And thank God for Sister Sally Craig and the First Wives Club. Amen. Now listen, I'm an observant person, and I kept seeing all these women come up here with this First Wives Club, and I kept looking at these rings. I said, well, somebody doing something right, because I'm seeing some nice little bling bling up here. Amen. The husbands ain't saying much, just standing back strong. That's what I'm talking about. Amen. I thank God for having wonderful friends and to celebrate this friendship day. How many of you are glad that you have friends in your life? Now, I know there's some people that say, I ain't got no friends. I don't need no friends. But I thank God for my friends. Amen. A real friend is a person that if they're with people and the people get ready to talk about you, before they tell you what the people said about you, they tell you what they did to shut it down. Those are real friends. I like when I get those phone calls and people say, you know, they didn't know that we were friends, but when they got ready to say something, I said, wait just a minute now. That's my brother. That's my friend. And I like those kind of friends. I know some of us only used to shady friends, but I thank God for having some good friends. Amen. Some people that you can tell your deepest, darkest secrets, and you don't have to worry about them telling your business to anybody else. But a friend that will tell you not only when you're good, but a friend that will tell you when you're wrong. We don't like those kind of friends. Those are the kind of friends we ghost for a little while. We ghost them for a few weeks because they done said something that touched the nerve and you don't want to deal with it. So you don't fool with them. But your friend, your real friend, will let you cool off and give you enough time to say, now, are you ready to talk now? So you ought to praise God every time you have a friend. I thank God that my best friend in the whole wide world, she's not here today, but it is my beautiful wife. And this year we celebrated 21 years. Amen. 21 years of not just being married, but enjoying ourselves together, having a good time. When we got married, we were 25, and sound wisdom told us, let's not have children right away. Let's get an opportunity for us to enjoy ourselves. And about 3 years later, we had our first child, and then we waited 6 years and had our second. And God has been blessing us, and we're looking forward to the second half of life. We got a 12-year-old, and soon and very soon, she'll be going to college somewhere. And God, I told my wife, I said, now it's just going to be me and you. We got to have fun. We got to do something. And she's not here today. I told her I was going to tell on her. My wife works for Kaiser. And we had bought tickets and we got our hotel to go to Las Vegas this evening. And because Kaiser was going to strike, we didn't know if that trip was going to happen until yesterday at about 1 o'clock. And so my wife said, please tell them that I miss them and I'll see them next time. But my wife is not the type of person that leaves the house nasty. Y'all didn't say nothing to me. Let me say that again. My wife, maybe y'all don't know me. Y'all get to know me in a minute. My wife is not the type of wife that leaves the house nasty when you go on a trip. You got to clean that house because you got to come home to that house. And some of us, if we would clean up the chaos, we wouldn't be so chaotic when we come home. You come home and your bed looked like you was in a hurry. You got clothes everywhere, shoes everywhere. A little chaotic. But God helps us. Y'all gonna get to know me after a while. There's a reason why I asked to speak down here, because you know sometimes when you get to an elevated place, people kind of filter out what you say because of who you are. But when I can get on your level and talk to you in your eye, then all we have between us is the truth of God's word. Amen. And since we brought up the word of God, let's turn to Romans chapter 12. Romans chapter 12 and verse 10 is your thematic scripture that you have selected. Romans 12 and 10. And I don't want to have you up and down, but let's stand in the reverence to the reading of God's word. I'm going to read this. And there are three translations. I want to read it in first, the King James Version, Romans 12 and 10. Be kindly affectioned to one another with brotherly love, in honor, preferring one another. The Living Bible says it this way. Love each other with brotherly affection and take delight in honoring one another. Then Dr. Eugene Peterson's Message Bible says it this way. Love from the center of who you are. Don't fake it. Run for dear life from evil. Hold on for dear life to good. Be good friends who love deeply. Practice playing second fiddle. I want to talk or use as a thematic question today, what kind of friend are you? Will you just say that with me? What kind of friend are you? You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. If I was going to preach this another way, I would ask the question, do you play well with others? For the past 3 or 4 years, and I brought some flyers with me because I'm working with the Head Start program, and we have new sites that have opened up in this area, and I feel like no parent should not be able to go to work or do what they can do because they have a 2 to 5 year old that they have nothing to do with. But there are Head Start programs that you will qualify for, amen? So I'll put some flyers out in the back, but I want to make sure that while I'm doing the work of the Lord, I'm doing the work of the Lord. For the past 3 or 4 years, I've had the opportunity to work in an atmosphere or atmospheres where children are present. I've been blessed to not only do ministry in the realm of the church, but my job is providing resources to families. I would often take moments while working to study the children as they would play outside on the playground. I got to see early microaggressions and manipulative strategies to get what they wanted. I would see how one child would become angry with another child and try to convince the whole class not to play with the child who they don't like. Children playing outside. I noticed how these little 2 to 5 year olds had the cognitive ability to throw a tantrum in an attempt to change the rules to accommodate their personal wants. The more I looked at the children, I started to look at the staff. To my surprise, some of the same attitudes, microaggressions, and behaviors that I saw in the children, I could see in the staff. Grown folks who still use manipulative tools and strategies to get what they want. In the event that they don't get what they want, even the grown folks will throw a tantrum on you. Oh, y'all ain't talking to me in here. They'll throw a tantrum on you to accommodate what they want. This was so evident in the workplace that we began a study by Dr. Travis Bradbury and John Graves entitled Emotional Intelligence 2.0. The purpose of this book is to succinctly explain how to deal with emotions creatively and employ our intelligence in a beneficial way. The book was written to help you become self-aware, self-management, social awareness, and relationship management. You've got to be self-aware. Knowing yourself as you really are. I know you brought your church self to church. And I know you got work personalities, but that's not always who you really are. See, your friend is your friend because they know you're crazy and they love you in spite of your crazy. The behind closed doors you, managing yourself and your relationships means you first need to be aware of the full range of your feelings. Know when you're gonna get crazy, both positive and negative. Just as you know your strengths, we all have areas of weakness that require emotional intelligence. Will you look at somebody and say, he's gonna help your friendship? The other thing you have to look at is self-management. Everybody say self-management. Your ability to use awareness of your emotions to actively choose what you say and do, to express your feelings and act accordingly to the benefit of the relationship.
You have to be socially aware to better understand the other person's needs and feelings before you consider your own. And then relationship management, the process of building and maintaining strong relationships. The overall theme of emotional intelligence is to be aware of yourself, aware of your surroundings, managing how you get through situations, and protecting and cultivating strong relationships. I know we're all adults in the room. However, there are those who choose to ignore behaviors that have jeopardized and harmed great friendships. All of us have encountered people who have a problem playing with others. Before we called it emotional intelligence, my grandfather would simply say, "You gotta act like you got good sense." He would also say, "Common sense ain't common." I thank God for being raised around seasoned, mature people who believed in transferring wisdom. Much of the wisdom they shared, that they gave to us, could be found in the book of Proverbs. I know we don't preach from it often. It's not mystical enough. I know we leave it to our private study, but we need wisdom. Will you look at somebody and say, "You need wisdom"? It is the book of Proverbs, and my dear little sister read the wonderful passage in Proverbs 17. But I like to read Proverbs 18, because when you're dealing with people, every now and then I call it a P18. You got to go to Proverbs 18, because Proverbs 18 teaches you how to deal with fools. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me in here. Yeah. Proverbs 18 will teach you. I know we were taught not to say that, but it says it in the text. It taught us how to deal with fools. Proverbs 18:1 says, "Unfriendly people care only about themselves. They lash out at common sense." Why are you trying to be friends with these people when the Bible tells you they're fools? Proverbs 18:2 tells us, "Fools have no interest in understanding." Some of y'all will save yourself a whole lot of time if you just know they're in a foolish season. They not listening no way. They only want to air their own opinions. Proverbs 18. Some of y'all gonna pull out a P18 this week. 6:7 says, "A fool gets into constant fights. His mouth is undoing. His words endanger him. What dainty morsels rumors are, they're eaten with great relish." Listen, this is Proverbs 9 telling us, "A lazy man is brother to a saboteur." Some of y'all would have stopped a whole lot of situations had you read Proverbs 18. If anybody is lazy in your house, they're going to sabotage what you're trying to do. Y'all, you talking to your friend, "We're going to go to the next level." Yeah, we're going to do it. We're going to build it. We're going to make it happen. And then here they come with a mess and drama, and you can't get nothing done because they sabotage everything. The mouths of fools are their ruin. They trap themselves with their lips. Proverbs 18:19, "An offended friend is harder to win back than a fortified city. Argument separates friends like a gate locked with bars." Wisdom shows us who we're dealing with all the time. However, it's us to determine the action we'll take. The wisdom of Proverbs tells us how to deal with emotional intelligence. But then, as we go into Romans chapter 12, where our text is found, Paul opens the chapter with a distinction. He's not talking to everybody. He's not just talking to anybody, but this portion of the letter is written to believers. He opens by saying, "I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual act of worship, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. He's not only talking to believers, however, he's making a hard request that they would present their bodies as a living sacrifice to God. You notice he didn't say your mind, he said your body. This is something you got to do. Everybody say self-denial. The denial of one's own interests and needs. He also asked that we be not conformed to the world, but be transformed by the constant cleansing of our minds. So verse 1 of chapter 12 tells us that we first got to let self go. Everybody say, let self go. I'm sorry to say it to you, but it's not always about you. Sometimes you got to understand it's not your day. Can you just say it? It's not my day. Sometimes in order for your friendship to win, you have to know when it's not your day. He says, dear brothers, I plead with you to give your bodies to God. Let them be a living sacrifice, holy, the kind he can accept. When you think of what he's done for you, is this too much to ask? Don't copy the behavior and customs of the world, but be new and different with the fresh newness in all you do and think. Then you will learn from your own experience how his will really satisfy you. I'm surrendering my will in exchange for him. So I understand that it's not all about me. I've got to let self go, but you also must understand you are necessary. Will you lay your hands on yourself and say, I am necessary. As God's messenger, I give each of you God's warning. Be honest in your estimate of yourselves, measuring your value by how much faith God has given you. Just as there are many parts to our bodies, so it is with Christ's body. We are all parts of it, and it takes every one of us to make it complete. For we each have different work to do. You've got a part to play in this. Sometimes as a friend, you're the listener. Sometimes you're the talker. But you got to understand when it's time to listen and not talk. You are necessary. The scripture also tells us, this chapter tells us, before we can get to the brotherly love, we have to stay in our own lane. Woo! Now, y'all looking at me kind of funny, but I know this is hitting some of y'all because you want me to hoop and holler, but I need you to stay in your own lane. God has given us abilities to do certain things well. So if God has given you the ability to prophesy, then prophesy well. But don't hate on the ones that can prophesy well because you ain't got that gift. Come on here. You don't sing good to yourself in the shower. So that means that you are not called to the praise team. But don't hate on the praise team because that's not your area. If it's your gift, is that of serving others, serve them well. No matter if they call you a flunky or not, you're doing this as unto the Lord. If you're a teacher, do a good job as a teacher. If you're a preacher, see that your sermons are strong and helpful. And if God has given you money, be generous in helping others with it. Ooh, I came down the street right now. I said money and I felt the room get cold. Come on, why y'all playing now? In the midst of this pandemic, I lost about 50 people that I knew. Across the country, I lost about 50 people that I knew. But before the pandemic, in 2018, me and my wife decided that we were going to commit to tithing. We committed. We said, you know what? No matter what, off the top, we're going to pay our tithes. We're going to do this together. And now that I look back on it, my brother, let me tell you, I went from hourly to exempt in the midst of a pandemic. Some of y'all don't know what I just said. I went from hourly, where you got to clock in hourly, to being the person that's checking the time to make sure you did it right. I went from the subordinate to the supervisor in the midst of a pandemic. My income quadrupled. in the midst of a pandemic. Don't tell me what God won't do. I don't care if I've been stingy before, I ain't stingy now. In the midst of a pandemic, I went from going to the grocery store and trying to count up how much I got to not even worrying about what I got. I just go up there and whatever they say, it's all good, because I made a decision to do what was right by God. Ooh. I look for people to bless. I look for opportunities to bless folks. I know this is a little off subject, but listen, I will walk up to you at the gas station and ask you, can I fill your gas tank up today? Y'all didn't say nothing. I'm talking to some folk that's trying to be on some next level blessing, because you know you serve a next level God, and God has the power. Oh, I felt something happening right there. I need about 25 people that know God's about to increase you to open up your mouth and give God a shout right there. Yeah. You can shout under your mask, but I felt God move right there. Hallelujah. I don't know what's about to happen in this church, but I speak property. I speak property. I thank God for the apartments. Don't tell me what God can't do. Come on, while we're doing this, just take a few moments and speak into your own life. Come on, speak into your own situation that blessings are coming into my house. Blessings are coming into my life. Yeah. I know some of you wondered what just happened. That's when the Holy Ghost comes into the room. My brothers and sisters, after we stay in our own lane, somebody say, stay in your lane. Woo, I got to stay in my lane because my lane is a blessed lane. My lane is a higher lane. I feel that in the Holy Ghost right there. There's somebody that's getting ready to get an unexpected promotion on your job. I don't know who you are, but you're pulling on my spirit right now. I just need you to praise God for the work being done right now. See, while y'all playing, I feel God in here. While y'all playing, there are some folks that didn't want to get vaccinated. And they sitting in a seat right now. But that seat got an expiration date on it. And while you're sitting here in church, God is saying, you're next. I wish you would just look at somebody and say, you're next. You're next. Your miracle. Somebody is getting ready to move across country and they just bought a brand new house, but you're next. Yeah. Ooh, I feel God in this room. I feel God in this room. Hallelujah. I got to get back to the sermon. But there's some people in here been praying for a house. You've been praying for a house, and it don't seem like you can afford the kind of house you want in LA. But God said, I'm getting ready to show you a miracle. I don't know who you are, but those that have been looking at that four-bedroom house with the three bathrooms and the pool in the back, I need you to open your mouth and shout right now, because listen, I'm sorry, but this is a post-pandemic Mike Davis. I'm going to praise him anywhere. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Woo. I need you to give somebody a high five and tell them, I'm going to get them keys. I'm going to get them keys. I'm going to get them keys. Yeah. Y'all have a seat. I got to go. Woo. Yeah. I don't know who I'm preaching to, but somebody need to praise him right there. Woo! You didn't think you could get it because it's $2.5 million, but God said, I'll bring the price down so you can get it. Woo-wee. That lady that keeps screaming back there, lift your hands. Are you all together? You all stand together. I feel the Holy Ghost. I want you to join hands together. Because what I want to tell you, my sister, is that you went through the process, and it seemed like while you were going through the process, the enemy tried to do bring up old stuff on credit, tried to bring all kinds of stuff to shut it down. But God said he made you a promise, and because he made you a promise, it shall come to pass. And everybody that will praise God with her, God said, I'm going to do the same for you. I feel it in this room. Unexpected finances, unexpected promotions. God, do it for your people. Woo! He's in the room. He's in the room. You may be sick in your body, but God is a healer. God is a deliverer. Hey, cancer be healed. Cancer be healed. God, heal the prostate cancer. Heal it, God. Woo! I'm trying to move on, but I just want you to start praising God. Just start praising God right now. God's going to show you. He is a miracle worker. Yeah. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm trying to move on, but I feel a praise right here. I feel a praise right here. Hallelujah. The Lord is about to show you. Glory to God. He's going to show you. He's a miracle worker. I'm trying to move on, but there's a lady in that black polka dot back there. Somebody tell her to get to the aisle. Get to the aisle. My sister, I need you to understand. And I need about 25 people to shout when I tell her what I'm going to tell her. This is your last week to be in lack. This is your last week to be in lack. God is about to come through. Have your seats if you can. Have your seats. I got, the other day, I went out and I checked my mail, and I feel God is just shifting this thing right here. I went out and I checked my mail, and I had a white envelope that says Sioux Falls. And I said, now I'm getting ready to throw this junk mail away. But before I threw the junk mail away, I said, let me open it up and see what it is. And it was a card that I wasn't used to seeing at my house, but it was an EBT card. Y'all looking at me strange. An EBT card. I work in the hood. I got some hood in me too. That EBT card, the first one came, and I said, let me call and see what they're talking about. Well, when I checked the first one said that they were giving us $365 to go get groceries. I shouted. Oh, y'all looking at me. I said, I shouted. Then another card came. And I said, Lord, what is this card coming for? I went and checked the balance on that one. It says $765. Then another one came with my baby girl's name on it. And we wondered why the oldest one got one, but the youngest one didn't. But let me tell you, when the youngest one, when I checked her balance, it was $1,120. What they did was they went back and paid her for the back time. I said that to say this, it's just as quick as the card came is how quick your miracle is gonna come. And God is not just gonna give you what you need right now, but God said, I'm going back. I'm going back and I'm gonna bless you back. Some of y'all gonna get some back child support. While y'all tripping, you better shout. I gotta finish because we got to go. Ooh, my last thing, my last point before we shout. Y'all be seated. Love for real. Love for real. Ain't no time for fake stuff. I'm too old for fake. about a couple years ago, after I crossed over into 40, and I got to that 45, I started thinking about stuff. Started thinking about, hey, you know, retirement. Yo, come on here. Trying to have some generational money for my children. You know, need a house and some property. And I started thinking like that. But I noticed that there were certain friends that would call me when they wanted me to do something. Every time they wanted me to do something, they would call. But anytime I was doing something, I can't find them. Now, every time you got something going on, you call me, because you want me there. But then when I need you, I can't find you nowhere. And so because I am an outspoken person, I had a conversation with him, and I said, listen, let's not be fake about this thing. Let's keep it all the way real, bruh. Do you realize that you only call me when you want something from me? And then when I call you, I can't find you. And they had the nerve to say, well, I don't know too much of what's going on with you. Said, let's have a real moment. I love you because you're my brother in Christ, but you are not my friend. You're not my friend because friends love at all times. Friends are there, and that's not what you're trying to do. You're an opportunist. And I understand those opportunities. So let's just face this relationship from that vantage point. I don't have no problem with you. I love you. But you're not my friend. Y'all looking at me strange. Do y'all know how liberating that was? Do y'all know how y'all sitting here looking like, I ain't gonna say that. Some of y'all need to say that. You playing with people that's crazy. They draining you. They call you and tell you everything going on with them. And then when you get ready to say, well, I'm going to child, I got to call you back. Some friends are just as good as the next relationship they get into. They your friend until Bubba show up. Bubba show up, then I go, girl, I'm busy. I got stuff to do. I can't go. Honey, me and my man. And then when Bubba gone, they available. Sometimes I leave you in the realm of availability and let you see how that work out. Y'all looking at me strange. Love for real. Don't just pretend that you love others, but really love them. Hate what is wrong. Hate what's wrong. You know what's wrong. You know when you're getting ready to do something wrong. You know when you're getting ready to do something wrong to your friend. Y'all quiet up in here. Some of y'all done got over on your friend. Shame on you. You sitting up in church. You know it was only $50. You told them it was $120 because you wanted some extra. That's how the sanctified folk play games. You know, they give you a piece of what they owe you. $1,000. I need $1,000. I'm gonna give it to you next week. Because your friend got it. You know your friend got it. But here come next week. You sent the voicemail. Here come next week. You only speaking through text. Hate what is wrong. You know you took something from your friend's house. And they ain't recognize it's gone yet. You done wore the outfit out of town, had a good party, and then you done made up your mind. If they don't say nothing, I ain't gonna say nothing. Hate what is wrong. Stay on the side of good. Love each other with brotherly affection and take delight in honoring each other. Never be lazy in your work, but serve the Lord enthusiastically. As I close, even Jesus had to deal with a bad friend. A person that was close enough to kiss him, but cut him at the same time. All of us have encountered those individuals that you were trusted just enough to get your information, to go and totally take it and take it for granted that they were ever that close to you. Jesus had that one. His name was Judas. Judas was around Jesus. Judas knew Jesus. He was close to Jesus. But as soon as he had the opportunity to plot against Jesus, he took that opportunity. But what he failed to realize is that everybody played a fool sometime. And God will allow you to play the fool to get me where I need to be. Because if it had not been for Judas playing the fool, then Jesus wouldn't have went to the cross when he did. See, Judas thought, your friends think they doing something, but they don't understand rejection only sends me in the right direction. They don't understand that sometimes you've got to do me dirty in order for me to rise up. I'm going to say this. And I'm going to try not to hoop when I say it, because I still feel what I felt a few moments ago. But see, you got to understand, if you're going to understand a shady friend, you got to look at the rose. Why do I look at the rose? Because yes, you can dig a place for the rose. Yes, you can put dirt in the ground for the rose. But if you really want that seed to go, you got to put some fertilizer on it. Y'all ain't talking to me. Sometimes fertilizer is cow manure that they use. So when your friend thought they was throwing that on you, they didn't know they were just putting you in a position to grow. So the more mess that's been thrown on you, the stronger you become, the higher you grow. I need somebody to say, I'm growing through the mess. I'm growing through the mess, because this is my season to be connected with people that know something about the God I serve. Somebody that will pray with me. Somebody that will stand in the gap. And somebody that will celebrate my victories. I need you to look at your friend and say, hey, friend. Come on, look at him and say, hey, friend. I hope you're ready to party, because we both about to get blessed. Some of y'all ain't talking to your friend. I want you to talk to your friend like you talk to your friend and say, hey, friend, I hope you're ready to party, because God's about to bless us. Now clap your hands. Yeah. That's right. That's the kind of praise I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Everyone standing? Everyone standing? I'm done. Listen, I'm telling y'all, you can't go through a pandemic and make it and come to church the same way. Now, some of y'all was at home shouting in bonnets. You was at church, having church in your pajamas. You know, I got up on the side of my bed. I was watching the church, and they got to cutting up at a... I had to cut my step too. We were watching the church in New York. I got to watch churches in New York, in Texas, see how different people have church. And I was watching the AME church, but I thought they were Church of God in Christ because they shouted so much. And they had so much spirit in there. You know, some people, they done got accustomed to sitting down, looking quiet, and watching a show. But since I'm in the house of God, this is my opportunity to be with my brothers and sisters and tell God, thank you. Can I just take about 30 seconds of your time for you to open up your mouth and thank God for what he's getting ready to do? Come on, praise it. Come on, praise him. Praise him.
I feel like a praise break.
Hallelujah.
I feel like
hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I say I feel like a praise.
Hallelujah. I feel victory in the house. I feel victory in the house. Hallelujah. And so we're gonna pray. I know I've gone over my time. We're gonna pray. Woo! Oh, but I feel good in here tonight, this day. Listen, we're gonna pray. But I feel to pray. I wanted to do a prayer about friendships. I wanted to stay with your theme. But I feel like praying for miracles. Now listen, I feel like praying for miracles and breakthrough this week. Hear me. I heard Bishop Jake say a few weeks ago that we're coming into a seismic shift. What God did in my life, the same department that I was working in, in 11 months, I became the supervisor. I left the company I was with, started working with another company. I thought I was going to be with that other company. But then the person that I worked under got promoted. They reached out to me and said, I think you can do what I did. You don't often leave a company and go back. Okay. But I, like I said, I left hourly, but I came back exempt. It happened in a short period of time. That's just how quick God is about to move for some of you that are here today. It's according to your faith. If you believe God to do it, God will show it. This is not, this ain't for me to have a Benny Hinn moment. This is about you believing what God said he's going to do in your life and him working a miracle for you. My sister standing in front of me, I just want you to lift that hand up. Because there's a healing that's taking place in your body right now. And that spirit of fear that has been following you, a spirit of fear because the enemy wants you to think that this is death. But I want you to understand God said there is more life. Ooh, I can't get nobody to help me in here. I need you to take your own hand and lay it on your belly and say, I am healed. I am healed. I am healed. Come on, somebody open your mouth and give God a shout. Ooh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. We got to go. But I'm going to pray that this week God visits you. Ooh, I'm trying to move, Pastor. Y'all tell me when I got to go. There's a sister in the green back there. Lift your other hand. Lift your other hand. Because I need you to understand that while you're at church here, God is going to where you live. And there's some things that need to be moved out of that place. And God says, I'm going to move it while you're working. You're working, giving him worship. So while you're worshiping, God is going through that house right now and getting it out of there. I need somebody to say, Lord, touch my house. Touch my house. Woo. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Ooh, I feel God in this place. We thank you for your power. We thank you for your anointing. God, I pray that you will touch your people. God, that you will help us to be deliverance for our friends. Help us to connect with people that we can pray through. God, we thank you for what you've done. Thank you for this house. God, I speak blessings and miracles in this church. God, I pray that every person that has tithed into this ministry, God, I thank you that they will see the increase before this year is over. God, I thank you for moving before this year is over. And we give your name praise. Come on, if you believe God's going to bless you before December 31st with a crazy miracle, I need you to take 30 seconds and give him a shout.
I am so grateful for you. We are so grateful that you allowed the Lord to use you. And this is our token to you to say thank you. But no. So now we will have the presentation of gifts. For the First Wives, followed by remarks from our president of First Wives, Mrs. Sally Critt.
While we are preparing for that, I'm a preacher and pastor. I don't like to rush past a word. So I'm going to ask if anyone needs to come forward for help of any kind. After Pastor Davis has spoken, if you need to come forward, come forward. We're going to leave a time right now for that. If we need to stand, let's stand. You need prayer of any kind, let's move forward. God's spirit is in this place. We're not going to run past that. We want the Lord. This is the most important thing of your day and week, is for God to move in your life. Pastor put out so many blessings. If you didn't hear your name, come on up here and say, God, you add me to that. Lord Jesus, add me to that. Add me to that, Jesus. Add me to that, Holy One. Add me to that. Don't leave out of here when you can get help for something. Lord, add me to that. Let His Spirit move. Lord, add me to that. Lord, add me to that. Add my children to that. Add my seed to that. Lord, add me to that. You know what I've been through. Lord, add me to that. Sweet Spirit of God, send your peace. Send your healing. Send your wholeness. In the name of Jesus, Lord, add me to that. Add me to that. Add me to that. Father, add me to that. Whew. While on others thou art calling, please, please, don't pass me by. Add me to that, Holy One. Add me to that. Add me to that. Thank you, Jesus.
The healing of the Lord move across this altar now. Come on, just open up your mouth. Lord, we praise you. We glorify you. We honor you, Lord. Lord, I thank you that you're passing out miracles even now. God, we thank you. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you for helping the mothers, God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for your touch, God. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We give you glory now. In the name of Jesus. God, move by your spirit. Hallelujah. Come on, open up your mouth all over this altar. Lord, we praise you. Come on, those of you that are in ministry, help us pray. Hallelujah. If you're in ministry, help us pray. Father, we thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. God, we give you glory now. God, touch, heal, and deliver. God, touch, heal, and deliver. God, touch and make whole. In the name of Jesus. Come on, all over this room. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we glorify you. Lord, we magnify your name. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you today as we stand here. God, you know every person that stands on this altar. God, you know what they stand in need of. And Father, we thank you right now that you're answering prayer. God, we pray that you're answering prayer even now. God, as we call out to you on this altar, God, we thank you for deliverance now. God, we thank you for deliverance now. Come on, open up your mouth and say, I am delivered. I am healed. I am set free. Come on, say, I am delivered. I am healed. I am set free. I am delivered. I'm healed. And I'm set free. Now, if you believe it, put those hands together. And as you go back to your seats, I want you to tell somebody, God's already done it. Come on, tell somebody, God's already done it. God's already done it. He's going to stand with you. He's going to help you. He's already done it. He's already done it. My sister right here in this black, lift your hands. You've been working hard, and it seems like you're spinning your wheels, but God says, I'm about to send you help. I'm about to send the financial help that you need. But God said, I'm going to send the emotional help. Hey, I'm going to stand with you in this season of your life. I don't know what you lost, but God said, I'm about to show you that I am the God that provides. I am your provider. I need about 10 people to say provision. We speak provision in your life. Everything you need will be provided for. And God, I speak over this young man. God, I thank you that he will be a mighty man. God, that you will raise him up to be a smart businessman. God, we give you praise for what you're going to do in his life. God, I pray that you'll pay for his college, God. I thank you for paying for his education even now. In the name of Jesus, use him for your glory. Come on, somebody say glory. Hallelujah. Listen, I was trying to move on and get out of the way. But let me tell you, when you go into your house, I need you to start speaking miracles into your house. When you walk in the door, speak miracles into where you live. Declare miracles wherever you go. There's one last person I'm going to pray for, and then we're going to move. There's this gentleman in this black sweater. If you could just stand and lift your hands. Just lift your hand right back there. Father, I thank you for this young man. God is going to give you some ingenious ideas. Don't be afraid that what you write down is going to be what pays for your life. God is going to show you how to do what you need to do to get to your next level. I speak blessings into your life. I speak miracles into your life. God, use him to give answers to the world. God, we thank you for raising him up in this hour. I need everybody that's got a son, a nephew, a cousin to open up your mouth and say, God, I thank you for doing it. Yeah, yeah, it's gonna happen. Hallelujah. 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 I believe Sister Sally's coming. Whew. Isn't God all right? He all right.
Thank you, Pastor. Would all the first wives that are supposed to help with the presentation of the baskets go back and see Janet so she can tell you what to do and then come forward? While we're handing out gifts, the baskets, I would like to give thank yous. Thank you to all the first wives. And like Pastor said, this first wives is miraculous, really. It is. It really is. It's a wonderful group, and I always say, what you put in is what you get out. It's an awesome, awesome group. And I want to thank all of the first wives that participated in giving for the baskets and getting ready for this program. And I want to thank Reverend Mike and the Men's Fellowship for their donations to help us give out the baskets. I just want to thank everybody. I want to thank Pastor for that. For that passionate, soul-wrenching message. I thank you for that. We just bless you. And I want to, what else was it I was going to say? I had my little list. You know how that goes. I couldn't find it. But I just want to thank everyone. And again, I want to thank all of the friends that came, and we really appreciate you coming. And so, we have Friendship Day every year that around this time. So next year, bring a friend with you. We will appreciate that. And thank you.
I want to thank First Wives also for hosting Friendship Day faithfully every year. We do this as an extension of ourselves into the community, into the church body, into the world. Pastor Davis, thank you, thank you, thank you for blessing us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We are a word-hungry church. We love the word. We're not tired of manna. We don't complain when God sends us the word. We love the word. Even when it finds us, we're grateful because we know help is coming with the finding. So thank you this morning for the word. Thank you all our friends that have come. You're free to visit. You don't just have to wait for Friendship Day. You are free to visit whenever you feel the Spirit sending you this way. I want to thank our First Wives president, Sister Sally. I was president for a while, and I told her I got stuff to do at the church. So she became our full-time president. And to all of those that hold office, this has been a blessed day. Can we just give God a hand praise? And it would be rude of me not to acknowledge Sister Dorothy Thurman, who taught Sunday school when I first gave my life to the Lord faithfully, who helped us get anchored in the Word of God. We give you honor today. Thank you for being with us. We send blessings with you. We want you to know Brian stays in our prayers. And in our hearts, we are holding both of you up. So always know you have a family that cares and loves you both. Amen. To God be all the glory. He's done so many things in our lives. We bless and praise his name. I see my neighbors, Nathan. I have to wave to them. That's Kim and her husband, Tom. Thank you for coming. And to all of our friends today. As you see on the program, there is a meal for everyone, so stay for that. We do believe in outreach. As you see, we feed seniors 55 and over once a month with a good hot meal. So please stay for that. There is fellowship here.
Thank you guys for coming. Thank you, First Wives, for all of your giving and your support and your love. Amen. Reverend Holland, did you have anything you want to say? My husband. In fact, while he's coming, were you coming? No. Let's have, could our husbands stand? Could First Wives' husbands, or all the husbands in the church? All the husbands. We biblically understand that you guys gave birth to us. So we honor you today. Amen.
And I am going to close us out with a benediction. So if you could please stand. Our God and our Father, we thank you for this word that we have received on today. We ask that you allow us to hide that in our hearts so that we can have the faith that's necessary for those things to come to pass. Lord, we thank you so much for Pastor Davis. We thank you for each person that's here. We thank you for each of our friends. We ask that you bless the hands that prepared the food. We ask that you bless everyone who had every part in today, Lord Jesus. Remember our friends as they depart. We hope that they found a word in today that they can hide in their hearts that will bring them back to you, Lord Jesus. If they don't know you, Lord, we ask that they do come to know you the way that we know you. We just thank you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen.